Today I'm going to show you how to create the popular 3D image post in Facebook using Photoshop. Yes, you can turn your normal images or composites into 3D using the power of Photoshop and upload it to Facebook right from your computer. This feature is not anymore restricted to the iPhone. Today we're going to turn this composite into 3D. So without any further ado, let's get started. Back in the magical world of Photoshop, and if you want to go ahead and download this complete composite in the form of PSD with every layer intact, check the link in the description so that you can follow along. So first of all, we have the composite ready. All we need to create is the depth map. So before we do anything awesome, let us understand what are depth maps, or what are maps for that matter. Maps give us information about a particular area, right? Depth maps give us information about the depth of the image, or in other words, how far or near the objects are. And the way it does that is by using blacks and whites. The further the object is, the blacker it's going to be. The nearer the object is, the whiter it's going to be. Sometimes the color representation can be opposite, but the concept remains the same. Let's say the car is very far. It's going to be very dark in the depth map. And in the same image, the lamp post is very near to the camera. It's going to be very bright. So let's go ahead and create a depth map for this composite. So as you can see, the sky is the furthest from the camera. So let's go ahead and make it completely black. So create a new layer, and we can put it under the depth group. So let's press Ctrl or Command G with the layer selected so that it's all inside one group, and we can name this depth. Select this one, and you can name this sky if you wish to. Now let's go ahead and select the sky. You can choose any selection tool that you like. I'm going to use the pen tool. Press P for the pen tool, or select the pen tool right there. Now, let's make a selection of the earth and the sky and the outline over there. Click and drag, just like this. Now you can hold the Control or Command and play with the handle right there to make it accurate. It looks fine. Now let's complete it, bring it to the starting point, right click on it and choose Make Selection. There you go. Zero is fine, and hit OK. Now let's fill the sky with black. Make sure the foreground color is black, and then with the selection active, press Alt, Backspace or Option, Delete. It's black now. Press Ctrl or Command D. Now have a look at the earth. It goes from nearer to further. So we need to create one more gradient. So let's click on the new layer button right there. Place it under the sky. Now let's select the gradient. It should be from black to white or white to black, depending upon which direction you stretch. Further will be black, right? So I'm going to stretch from there to here. Fine. Let's start from the sun area and go until a little bit more. There you go. Now have a look at the line. This line is too harsh. We need to make it a little soft, right? So select the sky and then go to Filter, Blur, and then Gaussian Blur. Just a little bit of Gaussian Blur. Not so much, just a touch. Let's zoom in quite a bit here. About 4.9, or let's add 4.5 is fine for this example. Hit OK and we are good to go. Now let's add the cyclist. The advantage of making the depth group is that you can always turn it off for reference. Now first of all, let's name this Earth. Then we will work on the cyclist. All right, so let's turn it off for a moment and select the cyclist. Now, since this is a composite, we already have that layer, right? So let's go to the subject layer right there at the bottom. So this is the subject layer. Let's open up this group, and inside of that, we should have the subject. To make a selection of the objects of a particular layer, hold the Control or Command, click on the layer thumbnail to make a selection. Now, we can turn on the depth. Do you know what the color would be on the cyclist? The same color which is on the base of the earth, because it's on the same focal plane, right? So let's open up the group. Now above the sky layer, let's create one more new layer. We can name this cyclist. Now sample the color from the point where the tire touches the ground. Double click on in here. Then make sure sample all layers is selected. Just sample this color from right there. It's fine, and hit OK. Once that is done, press Alt, Backspace or Option, Delete to fill up the cyclist. Now press Ctrl or Command D. And we are pretty much good to go. Now it's time for us to add depth for the aircraft. So let's turn off the depth for reference. And now we need to make a selection of this area. So we can use the pen tool or any tool that is your favorite. So I'm going to choose the pen tool, select the pen tool, or press P to select the pen tool. And now let's make a selection of this area. Now to see the edges better, you can create a curves adjustment layer. You always know curves is always going to be my favorite. And pick up the shadows just to see this area properly. Now with the help of the pen tool, let's start making the selection. Now keep in mind, you have to be super accurate in here. If you want to learn how to use the pen tool, you can always watch this complete guide. And by the way, you can also use the quick selection tool, whatever is your favorite. It's almost done. Let's complete the path. From here, let's complete it from the outside. Doesn't matter how accurately you do it. From the outside, it just doesn't matter. Right click on it and choose Make Selection. Now, before we do anything, here's a warning. Once you have completed a path, let's just name it Aircraft so that you have it at your disposal in case you lose the selection due to any reasons. So Aircraft. There you go. It's saved right now inside of the Paths tab. Now let's go to the Layers tab and right click on it and choose Make Selection. Feather Radius 0 is fine for now and hit OK. Now we need to use Quick Mask to make the selection soft in some areas. So press Q to get to the Quick Mask mode. The areas which are selected are in color. The areas which are not selected are in red. You can always change the setting by double clicking on here and choose whatever color you like and what that color represents. I always keep it at these settings. Hit OK. You can choose whatever you want. Press Q to get back to the Quick Mask mode. And now, let's blur this area out. If I press Q again, these selections were meant to be a little softer, right? So press Q, select the blur tool right there. Click on in here, click on the group and select the blur tool. And let's start blurring it a little bit. 50% strength is fine. Let's just add a simple blur in there, right? Just a simple blur there as well. A little bit over there. Now, these were very sharp, so you don't have to add blur so much. Now, here there was a transition. So let's add some transition. Take the brush. The areas where you paint white, those areas will be selected. Where you paint black, those areas will not be selected. So take the brush, make sure the foreground color is white. Press X to toggle between the foreground and the background. Let's make the brush a little smaller. And let's draw this gradient right there. There we go. Once we are happy with this, press Q again. We are back to the selection. Now we can turn off these curves. We don't need this anymore. Let's turn on the depth. Now inside the depth, on the top layer. So let's select the topmost layer and click on the new layer button and fill this with white because it's the nearest to the camera. Make sure the foreground color is white. Press X to toggle between the foreground and the background. Alt, backspace or option delete to fill this up. It's looking pretty good, right? Now we are totally ready to upload it to Facebook. So first of all, let's turn off the depth group and save it as a complete image. So go to File, Export, Export As. You can choose PNG, you can choose JPEG. For this example, I'm going to leave it at PNG and click on Export All. Make sure the scale is 100%. Export All. Let's save it in a folder called Depth. And let's name it. This is very important. Naming is the most important thing. Let's name this Composite. Simple. And hit Save. Now let's turn on the Depth Map. And let's go to Export As again. Go to File, Export, Export As. It should be the same. It was 100%. It should be 100%. Everything same. And click on Export All. And this time in the same folder, let's name this one Composite underscore depth. Whatever the name of the main file was, just add underscore depth. A simple trick is just click on this file. This name will show up and let's add this underscore depth. And let's hit Save. Now we have both the images ready. All we have to do is to upload it to Facebook and let Facebook do the math. So here is my profile. So I'm going to click on Photo and Video. Locate the folder and select both of these images. So let's select both of them and click on Open. And Facebook will automatically do everything. Have a look, it's creating this 3D photo. Have a look at it. This is not bad. Wonderful, isn't it? Now you can play with the settings and everything. And once you're ready, once you're happy with everything, just click on Share. So that's how to create 3D image posts in Facebook using Photoshop. Or by the way, you can use any software you want. All you need is an image and it's depth map. That's it. Upload both of them in Facebook. Just keep in mind if the main image is named ABC, the depth map should be named ABC underscore depth and upload both of them and let Facebook do the math. And also keep in mind the nearer to the camera or the screen, the brighter, the further, the blacker. That's it. And it can vary in different platforms. Maybe Facebook just updates tomorrow and tells you the further, the whiter and the nearer, the blacker. But the concept will remain the same. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick or tutorial. I would like to take this moment and thank all these nice and amazing people for making this video possible and helping keep PiXimperfect free for everybody forever. Thanks so much for all your support. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.